welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to show you a very basic dough recipe, that is of pizza. It will be useful for making buns, stuffed buns, and even for calzones. So today I'm making a pizza dough recipe. So I will name it as a pizza dough recipe, but this dough will be used for making other things as well. So here I've got 3/4 cup of water, which is at lukewarm, and then I've got 2 cups of all-purpose flour, and then in the dry ingredients over here I've got 1/2 teaspoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon of yeast, and 1 teaspoon of salt. In this bowl I've already added water and I'm adding sugar to it. Sugar acts as a rising agent. It helps the yeast to rise. So I've added the yeast now, and now we can stir it, and I'm going to cover it and let it rise for about 10 minutes. Our yeast has risen very well. So now I'm going to add the all-purpose flour into it, and I'm also going to add the salt, and just we're going to stir to get the dough together. So we've got it together. So now what we're going to do, we're going to put it on the surface. Now my surface is clean. I've cleaned it very well. So now I'm going to put the dough over this, and just with the help of our palms, the fat portion, so we're just going to knead it like this. Just get it together. If you feel it is sticking, then you may take some flour and dust it and just get the whole flour together. Our dough is ready. You will know your dough is ready when it stops sticking to your hand, and when you press it like this, it should come up. So now I'm going to cut this dough into 2 parts, and then there's a way to fold it. So just hold it in your palms, turn it behind, squeeze, turn it behind, squeeze, turn it behind, squeeze, turn it behind, squeeze. So I'll show you one more. So we should get the seam at the back. So I'll show you one more now. Turn it behind, squeeze. Fold it behind, squeeze. Fold it behind, squeeze. So in the same way, just try to get, take very little olive oil into my palms and just put it around the bottom, and the seam over here will go down, and I'm just patting the dough with some oil so that we don't want any cracks on this. So we are going to just see again the seam. I'm going to put it into another bowl because this will rise, and we are going to cover it with a cling wrap or with a damp cloth and let it rest for about 1 hour. Now in case if there's winter in your place, then you may keep it for about 2 or 2.5 hours. So right now it's very hot over here in my place, so I'm going to keep it for only 1 hour or maximum for 1.5 hours.